dynamic that is already happening among us.
Rad bi osvetlil dinamiko, ki se že dogaja med nami.
And I want to highlight it because I want us to value it.
In jo želim osvetliti, ker želim, da jo cenimo.
To recognize its importance.
Da prepoznamo njeno pomembnost.
And to also protect it.
In da jo ravno tako tudi znamo zaščititi.
The Bible sets forth discipleship as an essential element of the church.
Sveto pismo podaja učeništvo kot zelo pomemben dejavnik cerkve.
There are different ways of phrasing the concept.
In seveda obstajajo različni načini, kako lahko to ubesedimo.
Mentoring is another form.
Drugo izraz bi bil mentorstvo.
The most popular today would be
najbolj popularno danes izraz pa je coaching.
Coaching is now
coaching
kind of the buzzword. The buzzword in business.
Popularna v podjetništvu.
Many individuals who've launched out to start their own coaching business.
Mnogi posamezniki so začeli svojo tržno nišo z coachingom.
And basically the idea behind it is just taking either a skill or something that we know and passing it on to someone else.
Ideja za tem stoji, da to, kar ti veš in znaš, predaš naprej nekomu.
Jesus set this out as one of the primary functions of the body of Christ.
In Jezus je postavil to kot primarno funkcijo telesa.
A coach is someone who usually has experience in a particular skill.
Coach, trener, mentor je oseba, ki ima na določenem področju posebno spretnost.
If anybody watches soccer or European football,
košarko,
basketball,
met,
right? Most of the coaches are previous players.
Večina trenerjev so bivši igralci.
Yeah, and the coach gets a little bit older.
Ko trener postane malce starejši.
And now he's got the younger guys.
Ima mlajše od sebe.
Because he's come out of that arena, he has his own experience and skill in that arena.
Zato ker je prišel iz tega področja, a ne, ima tudi določeno razumevanje in spretnosti na tem področju.
And one of his assignments is to help develop the strengths and the skills of others while also minimizing their weaknesses.
In ena izmed njegovih nalog, da razvija njihove spretnosti, področja, kjer so močni, in da jim poskuša pomagati minimizirati tista področja, na katerih so šibki.
One of the key factors of a coach's job is to help an individual work with the others on the team.
In ena izmed ključnih stvari je, da jim pomaga, da jih nauči, kako sodelovati v timu.
Yes, there are different kinds of coaches in terms of individual focus or team focus.
Seveda so različni trenerji, eni se specializirajo na ena na posameznike, drugi vodijo skupine.
The long-time coach of Novak Djokovic, Ivan
Goran.
Novak
Djokovića.
For an American, his last name is really hard to pronounce. Goran I. Yeah, it's just for short, I. Ivanišević, yes. He was a coach just for Novak Djokovic.
On je bil trener samo od Novak Djokovic.
During the most successful time of his career.
Najbolj uspešnim časom v njegovi karieri.
But Novak doesn't play a team sport.
Ampak Novak ne igra timskega športa.
So his role is a little different than a coach who has a team.
Torej njegova vloga je drugačna kot na primer za trenerja, ki vodi skupino.
In these concepts, I want us to understand that discipleship is the original term.
In v teh konceptih želim, da razumete, da učeništvo je v bistvu prvotni izraz.
And I still think it's one of the most important things that we can both here today and also implement.
In pomembno je, a ne, da to znamo, temu znamo prisluhniti in to tudi implementirati. Ne, zdaj sam še povem, da tudi v krščanskem svetu obstajajo tri različni izrazi discipleship, a ne, učeništvo, eni rečejo učenstvo, tretji rečejo učenčevstvo, tako da veste. Ne? In vsi trije se uporabljajo v različnih krščanskih krogih. Ne? Tako po slovensko, ko se ne moramo zediniti, ker bi bil najboljši izraz.
Učeništvo.
Učeništvo je nam najbližje, tako da mi tega uporabljamo.
It's what I first heard and it's still the term I use in Slovene, učeništvo.
Ja, ta termin je stil slišal prvič, ko je prišel pred več kot 30 leti v Slovenijo in ga pač mi še vedno uporabljamo.
Spiritual growth happens in the context of relationships.
Duhovna rast se odvija v kontekstu medsebojnih odnosov.
Relationships are the essence of discipleship.
Medsebojni odnosi so jedro bistvo tega učeništva.
That's what makes the online church.
Zaradi tega je ta spletna cerkev.
I wouldn't say problematic.
Ne bom rekel problematično.
Because there are benefits to watching things online.
So seveda tudi koristi tega, da nekaj gledaš preko spleta.
But that form of Christianity is very narrow and
oblika krščanstva.
Omejen.
Je na nek način omejena.
Limited in its ability and its scope. Consider that Jesus invested his life in 12 people.
Mislimo na to, da je Jezus investiral svoje življenje v 12 ljudi.
Spiritual growth doesn't happen in a vacuum.
Duhovna rast se ne zgodi v nekem vakuumu.
The kingdom of God moves forward through the energy and the dynamics of relationships.
Premika naprej preko energije, preko teh dinamičnih medsebojnih odnosov.
And the enemy will do everything in his power to try to isolate a believer from others.
In sovražnik bo naredil vse, kar je v njegovi moči, da izolira posameznika od drugih, da ga oddvoji.
From time to time I hear criticisms leveled against the church.
In časa do časa slišim različne kritike zoper cerkev.
And I think you would agree with me, many of those criticisms are valid.
In ja, mogoče bi se strinjali, nekatere kritike so povsem verodostojne. Mislim, so pač upravičene tako.
We are an imperfect community because we are imperfect people.
Nepopolna skupnost, ker sestojimo iz nepopolnih ljudi.
And the sooner that we accept that reality, we can learn to emphasize our strengths and try to minimize our weaknesses.
Se bomo naučili, a ne, ojačati te naše
strengths.
Močne točke in mogoče, a ne, kako se bomo naučili, kako ravnati z našimi šibkostmi.
We don't deny our weaknesses.
Ne negiramo, ne zanikamo naših šibkosti.
Our mistakes, our inability to love skillfully.
Napak ali pa sposobnosti, da bi spretno znali ljubiti drugega.
The ability to tame our tongue, which no one can do.
Sposobnosti, da ukrotimo ta jezik, katerega nihče ne zna popolno ukrotiti.
We can get better.
Lahko pa postanemo boljši v tem.
But sometimes we say things that wound other people.
Ampak včasih nehote rečemo stvari, ki prizadanejo druge.
And in the vast majority of cases, 99% of the time, it happens unintentionally.
Se zgodi nenamenoma.
We're good-willed.
Smo dobro namerni,
but sometimes unskilled.
Ampak včasih nespretni.
And if we can accept that as a reality, then we can stay a part of the essential element of being in a community and relationships.
Potem lahko postanemo to dejstvo, da smo sprejmemo to dejstvo, da smo v skupnosti, da smo v odnosih z drugimi.
My whole life has been marked by individuals who've invested themselves in me.
Moje življenje je nekako vplivano od posameznikov, ki so si vzeli čas in investirali.
They simply saw the value of spending time with me for my benefit. And I see that being reproduced over and over again among us. Many of you take that same initiative. And that's what spurs growth. That's what spurs excitement.
Navdušuje in kar daje rast.
Yes, signs and wonders are fabulous.
Znamenje in čudeži, to je krasno.
Healing is needed.
Ozdravljenje je potrebno.
Does anybody need a miracle?
A kdo potrebuje čudež?
Let's pray today for miracles to happen.
Torej, molimo danes, da se zgodijo čudeži.
In fact, we'll do it right before we leave the room today.
Preden bomo danes učili, bomo molili za to.
God can meet your specific need today.
Lahko poskrbi za tvojo konkretno potrebo prav danes.
That is one of the overall elements of the life of God.
Ena izmed mnogih stvari v življenju Boga.
But the path to maturity happens in the context of relationships. Ones that not only bless us, but also challenge us. Jesus called his followers to be his disciples.
Jezus je poklical svoje učence, da mu sledijo.
Go ahead.
Aha, tiste dni je šel na goro molit in vso noč je prebedel v molitvi k Bogu. Ko se je zdanilo, je poklical k sebi svoje učence in si jih je izmed njih izbral 12, katere je imenoval tudi apostole. Simona, ki ga je imenoval tudi Peter, njegovega brata Andreja, Jakoba, Janeza, Filipa, Bartolomeja, Mateja, Tomaža, Jakoba, Alfejevega sina Simona s priimkom Gorečnik, Juda, Jakobovega sina in Juda Iškariota, ki je postal izdajalec.
Notice their names.
Ste opazili njihova imena?
Matthew takes the energy to write their names specifically. Oh, I'm sorry, it's just Luca, sorry.
Yeah.
Because God knows them by name. And the people who will have the greatest influence on your life are the ones who know you by name.
In ljudje, ki bodo imeli največji vpliv na tvoje življenje, so tisti, ki te poznajo po imenu.
Names are important.
Imena so pomembna.
So much so that Luke took the energy to name them.
Tako pomembno, da si je Luka vzel čas, da je prav zapisal vseh 12 imen z njihovimi vzdevki.
And Jesus invested in them that they would do the same that he did for them.
In Jezus je investiral, si vzel čas za njih, da bi oni počeli to isto naprej.
Most of us are familiar with the Great Commission.
Vsi poznate to Jezusovo poslanstvo.
Matthew 28.
V Mateju 28.
Go ahead.
11 učencev se odpravilo v Galilejo na goro, kamor jim je Jezus naročil. Ko so ga zagledali, so se mu do tal priklonili, nekateri pa so dvomili. Jezus je pristopil in jim spregovoril. Dana mi je vsa oblast, nebesih in na zemlji. Pojdite torej in naredite vse narode za moje učence. Krščujte jih v ime Očeta in Sina in Svetega Duha in učite jih izpolnjevati vse, karkoli sem vam zapovedal. In glejte, jaz sem z vami vse dni do konca sveta.
Now all of the followers of Jesus were known as disciples.
Torej, Jezusovi učenci so bili znani kot učenci.
Yeah. Until we come to Acts chapter 11 and the church in Antioch.
Pridemo do apostolskih del 11, ko se srečamo z cerkvo v Antiohiji.
Where there comes a significant change in terminology.
Pride do spremembe izraza, do spremembe v terminologiji.
And we're told here that the disciples in Antioch,
in v Antiohiji so učenci,
they began to call them Christians. And this word was given to them not among themselves but by actually their antagonists.
In te besede si niso oni sami nadeli, ampak njihovi nasprotniki so jih tako poimenovali.
In fact, the people of Antioch, the culture,
kultura v Antiohiji,
they were known for making fun of others.
So bili znani po tem, da so se norčevali iz drugih.
And one of the ways that they did that was to assign labels to people. It's certainly not a new skill. It still happens today. So they were the ones, the people who labeled them as Christians. And
ljudje v Antiohiji so poimenovali Jezusove učence kristjane kot neko posmehljivko.
To je zmanjševanje, or it means little anointed one or little Christ.
To je v bistvu pomenilo mali Kristusi.
Kristjančki.
Kristjančki.
Neko v tem smislu, they were, to je neko, wasn't meant to be a compliment to them.
It was a mišljeno kot kompliment za njih.
It was a criticism.
Ampak kot kritika, kot neka posmehljivka, no.
And the identity of being a disciple or a learner, a follower of Christ has mostly been replaced with being a Christian.
Se je potem ta izraz učenec se potem zamenjal z imenom kristjan.
But disciple means a process is set in motion that has an end.
Biti učenec pomeni, da se je začel nek proces, ki nima konca.
And the end of discipleship is to become like your teacher.
In zaključna faza tega učeništva je, da postaneš tak, kakršen je tvoj učitelj.
And who is your teacher?
In kdo je tvoj učitelj?
Jesus. Jesus is your teacher.
Jezus je naš učitelj.
You follow him.
Mi sledimo Jezusu, ne?
And God will use people in the process to help spur your growth, but he is your teacher.
Da ti pomagajo krasti, ampak Jezus je tvoj učitelj.
And he is the one that you are being formed to become like.
On je ta, v katerega se ti preoblikuješ, da postaješ njemu podoben, Jezusu.
The Greek word itself for disciple means a learner, which is perfect in Slovene.
Pomen te grške besede je učenec, kar imamo v slovenščini lepo prevedeno.
Učenec, a learner, which defines one of the most important elements of the Christian life.
Kar v bistvu definira enega izmed pomembnih elementov krščanskega življenja.
All of us are learners.
Vsi smo učenci.
We're all in the same class together.
Vsi smo v istem razredu.
Wow. Yeah, that's a good idea. We need to start using In fact, my journey to Christ happened by asking a question.
Torej moje popotovanje Kristusu se je začelo z vprašanjem.
Which is the tool of a learner.
Ki je v bistvu orodje učenca.
What do learners do?
Kaj učenci počno?
They ask questions.
Sprašujejo.
Yeah. And I remember coming home on a Friday night, I was
spomnim v petek zvečer, ko sem se vračal domov.
Not real happy with where my life was going.
Nisem bil zadovoljen za svojim lastnim življenjem.
And I humbled myself.
In sem se ponižal.
I saw something in my brother that I
that was
actually attractive.
Kar mi je bilo privlačno.
And so I took on by a miracle because this wasn't my nature.
To ni bila moja narava takrat.
Jaz sem mislil, da sem pameten, da sem jaz vse vem. Pa sem zabluzil. In pridem domov in prvič iskreno vprašam. Brian, a je več od življenje kot samo žuranje? I was seeking an answer.
In sem iskal odgovor. Is there more to life than just partying? He asked his brother.
I was lost.
Bil sem izgubljen.
I needed help. And I asked a question.
In sem zastavil vprašanje.
That question, friends, opened the door for me to Christ. My brother was so faithful to tell me the right things. And that night, I gave my life to Christ. He came in and became my teacher. And he started to rearrange my life in a way that was more pleasing to him than to me.
Da je bilo moje življenje, da je bolj ugajalo njemu, kakor meni sam.
My value system was upside down.
Moj sistem vrednot se je spremenil.
I needed help to see what was good and what was bad.
Potreboval sem pomoč, da mi nekdo pokaže, kaj je dobro in kaj je slabo.
I had eaten from the tree of knowledge of good and evil.
Jaz sem sicer jedel od drevesa spoznanja dobrega in zlega.
I was making my own decisions about what I what I knew was right.
Delil v svoje lastne odločitve, po svoji lastni presoji, kaj sem si mislil, da je dobro.
In kako sem jaz grešil. Totalno. And then God comes in and he starts to rearrange your value system.
Potem vstopi Bog in začne spreminja tvoj sistem vrednot.
And you become a learner.
In postaneš učenec.
The second characteristic of being
druga značilnost
a disciple is not so evident in Slovene, but it is in English.
Ni tako evidentno v slovenščini, kakor v angleščini.
Because it's the characteristic of discipline.
Ker je to značilnost discipline.
Disciple comes from the same core word, discipline, disciple. Many Christians don't like to hear the word of discipline. Težko.
Učenec se uči, se ga vzgaja, se ga trenira, kara. Vse to ena beseda, disciplinira.
So it means to train, to form, to regulate, to correct, to chasten, to discipline, in other words, in a form of punishment, but punishment for the purpose of change. So a disciple is someone who follows to learn and learns to follow. You can't be a disciple without discipline.
Ne moreš biti učenec brez neke discipline.
A person can't grow up or become mature in Christ
lahko odraste, postane zrela v Kristusu
without the ability to learn under discipline.
Sicer lahko odraste, ampak se nikoli ni naučil, kako se mogoče podrediti, biti discipliniran,
se predati en določen pot.
Se ni naučil predati vzgoj.
It's very easy for a business person or for someone involved in sports to understand this concept.
Nekdo, ki je mogoče športnik ali pa podjetništvo, mu je lažje se naučiti oziroma razumeti ta koncept.
Because the goal that you set out
ker cilj, ki si ga zastaviš,
automatically places certain demands on how you use your time and energy.
Enostavno postavi neke zahteve na tabo, kako boš uporabljal svoj čas in svojo energijo.
If I want to become the best in my sports discipline,
če želim postati najboljši v svoji športni disciplini,
then everything about what I do in terms of what I eat, when I get up in the morning, when I go to bed, how I exercise, whether I go to that party event or not, all of that comes under the umbrella of trying to reach that goal. If I have a business and I got a business plan, I got a goal that I'm moving toward, then my sleep, my time, my prosti čas, vse je podrejen mojemu cilju in kam jaz grem ali kaj si želim, moj cilj. And the same is true as a disciple.
In isto velja za učenca.
What's my goal?
Kaj je moj cilj?
To become like Christ.
Da postanem kakor Krist.
To become like Him, both in my character, in my passions.
Da postanem kakor On, kar se tiče mojega značaja.
In joining Him in building His church.
Da se pridružim njemu in skupaj z njim gradim cerkev.
If Paul were around today, he would probably be confused by some of the average Christian's speech.
Če bi bil Pavel danes živ, bi bil mogoče malce zmeden glede določenega krščanskega žargona.
Paul comes to Ljubljana.
Na primer, Pavel pride v Ljubljano.
Hey Paul, our church is located in Zadobrovi.
Hey Pavel, naša cerkev se zbira v Zadobrovi.
He might have a nervous breakdown first.
Mogoče bil mal.
No, he wouldn't. But he would say this, listen, the church is not where you go. The church is who you are.
bistvu pomeni kdo si ti.
That's why I become a little bit confused by some individuals who feel so free to criticize the church of which they are a part.
Včasih je težko, ne, kadar ljudje kritizirajo cerkev, katere del, katere sami so del.
Slovenci, vi imate en lep izraz. To je nekdo, ki...
pluva v lastno skledo.
Ki pluva v svoje lastno skledo. Če lahko še bolj karakteriziram tega izraza. Don't do that.
Ne tega delam.
God wants you to be a part of the solution. The fact that someone can point out a problem in the church, hello, you are no Einstein.
Dejstvo, da znaš pokazati na težave v cerkvi, to ne še ne pomeni, da si Einstein.
But you will become an Elon Musk when you will provide a solution to the problem. And God's calling us to be solution providers.
Postanemo te, ki najdejo, ki iščejo rešitve, poskrbijo za rešitve.
Because we are the body of Christ and we carry his nature, his DNA.
Kristusovo telo in mi nosimo njegovo naravo, njegov DNK.
On je znano kot rešitelj. And that's what we do. Rešujemo.
To je to.
We are providing answers, solutions, help. We are the body of Christ. So you know the church is not a building, but it's a body of related people. We are connected. These are unseen or invisible bonds. And God loves those bonds.
In Bog ljubi te vezi.
The bond you have with him is invisible.
Vez, ki jo imaš z njim, je nevidna.
But that bond is beautiful.
Ampak ta vez je čudovita.
Because on the basis of that bond,
ker na osnovi te vezi,
there's an exchange of life.
Se dogaja izmenjava življenja.
Through that bond, what he has comes to you,
a ne, ker ma on pride do tebe,
and what you have goes to him. And it's the same concept in our relationships with one another. Through connections that we have, there's the ability to experience an exchange. And every one of us in this room has something to give. Every one of us in this room has an element to provide strength and to help the body become stronger.
Ki lahko pomaga telesu, da postane močnejši.
If you are born again,
če si na novo rojen,
then you are a member of that body.
Potem si del tega, si ud tega telesa.
And that body is corporately unified under the leadership of the Holy Spirit, Jesus Christ being the head.
In to telo je skupaj združeno, ko je Jezus Kristus glava tega telesa.
And when the body gets alive,
in ko telo oživi,
when the body gets coordinated,
ko je telo koordinirano,
disciplined,
ko je disciplinirano,
we become the image of Christ to Slovenia.
Potem postanemo mi skupaj kot telo podoba Jezusa Kristusa.
And I see so much discipleship and coaching happening in our circles.
In vidim toliko učeništva ali pa coachinga, ki se dogaja v naših krogih.
And I love it.
In to mi je všeč.
I love it.
To mi je zelo všeč.
You don't know how grateful I am for many of you in this room who take the initiative because you see value in other people and you want to invest because you know that those bonds, those relationships, they're the life of the church. And it's not only a one-way street. In all of my relationships, you've so enriched and benefited my life.
Vi ste tako obogatili moje življenje.
That there's no way I could ever pay you back.
Da ni nikakršnega načina, kako bi lahko to odplačal, povrnil nazaj.
You were the avenue through which you both challenged me and blessed me.
Vi ste bili v bistvu to orodje, ki me na nek način izzvalo, pa tudi blagoslovilo.
And there is so much to learn from one another if we are teachable.
Toliko se lahko naučimo drug od drugega, če smo le učljivi.
When a bond of trust and friendship is built,
in ko je zgrajena ta vez zaupanja in
friendship and trust,
prijateljstva in zaupanja,
then influence occurs.
Potem se dogaja, se zgodi ta vpliv.
And it happens in both directions.
In tak, medsebojni vpliv, v obe smeri.
It's never in one direction, it flows both ways.
Nikoli ni samo enosmerna cesta, ampak je vedno dvosmerna.
You have something to impart,
ti lahko nekaj predaš naprej,
and you have something to receive.
In imaš nekaj, kar lahko sprejmeš.
Barbara gave a litany of all the various groups and opportunities that are available.
Barbara je povedala različen cel seznam raznih skupin, priložnosti.
I think it's fantastic.
Mislim, da je to krasno.
And even beyond the existence of those groups,
in še preko teh skupin,
many of the individual contacts, the phone calls, the meetings over coffee, the
medsebojne kontakte, odnose, se dobite na kavo, se pokličete.
To je zlato vredno. Zlato vredno. And it's not always easy to measure those kinds of things.
In ni vedno lahko nekako meriti te stvari.
Yeah. How big is your church? How
many, velika je vaša crkva?
Right, that's a big question for
ponavadi je to vprašanje za
pastors hang out together.
Pastori, ko se dobijo,
koliko ste imeli na nedeljo?
Velika je vaša crkva?
Although that's very, very rare today, at least in the circles here in Slovenia.
V Sloveniji to ni tako običajno.
Because that's not the measure of success.
Ne, da to ni neka mera uspeha. Ampak v zuniji pa zelo pogosto vprašanje.
There are other measures of success.
Ampak so druga merila uspešnosti.
And we can see among ourselves, yes, that there are new people entering into life with Christ.
Čudovito je, ko novi ljudje vstopajo v življenje s Kristusom.
More and more individuals who are coming into an awareness,
več in več posameznikov, ki vstopajo v to zavedanje,
of what God has given them,
kaj jim je Bog dal,
as He heals their own wounds, their past, He gives them a fresh vision for what, for who they are and what they can do. And they begin to seek out other people that they can demonstrate that they have value. And when that snowball begins to move, and it's been moving for some time, it's hard to stop.
To težko zaustaviti.
The enemy will do everything he can.
Sovražnik bo naredil vse, kar je v njegovi moči.
To blast that snowball.
Da bi razbil to kepo.
That's why it's important that we recognize the value of people, of relationships.
Pomembno, da se zavedamo vrednosti ljudi, vrednosti medsebojnih odnosov.
We don't always get things right. We hold things loosely.
Da bo nam vedno vse krasno uspelo. Zato tudi stvari na lahko.
And one of our goals for a church comes from Romans chapter 15 verse 14. When Paul thought about the church in Romans, and not everything about the church in Rome was great.
In seveda ni bilo vse krasno v tej cerkvi.
In fact, Paul points it out in his letter.
Pravzaprav Pavel tudi pokaže v svojem pismu.
They had some challenges.
Da so imeli določene izzive.
And he was fine for pointing them out. But listen to what he says to the church at the conclusion of his letter.
Prepričan sem pa o vas, moji bratje, tudi jaz sam.
Pa sestre tudi so vključeni, da veste.
Da ste že sami polni dobrote, napolnjeni z vsakršnim znanjem, zmožni tudi drug drugega opominjati, svariti, poučevati, vzgajati.
Drug drugemu.
Drug drugega.
Their relationships among themselves were such that,
njihovi medsebojni odnosi so bili taki,
that Paul believed that what was in them,
Pavel verjel, da to, kar je v njih,
that there was an ability to encourage one another,
da drug drugega ohrabrijo,
svariti,
posvarijo,
poučevati,
poučijo,
and on the basis of that, the church in Rome
in na osnovi tega je cerkev v Rimu
was a lighthouse for that city.
bila svetilnik za tisto mesto.
I want to encourage us as a church.
Želim ohrabriti nas kot skupnost.
Let's value discipleship, learning.
Da cenimo to učeništvo, da cenimo to, da se lahko učimo.
Being a learner.
Da smo učenci.
I have much to learn in the arena of prophecy and prophetic.
Jaz imam še veliko za naučiti na področju preroštva.
As do many of us.
Kot seveda mnogi.
And thank God for Ursha and a team who are moving forward in that direction, providing input. I don't know how you experience, but when Borut was explaining the content of his course, I'm like, where's the sign-up list?
Jaz
moram odvit ponedeljke zvečer. Ker it sounds fantastic. Yeah, I know we do. I know. Because it sounds fantastic, because I have something to learn from Borut. LL has been functioning for years in Slovenia. And will continue to provide a context for believers to learn how to live intimately with God. How to let go of things that have been hanging on to them that they don't need to wear any longer. And I could stand here with a whole litany of opportunities and things that are available. Wow, fantastic. And in addition to all that, thank you for every phone call.
Hvala za vsak telefonski klic.
Thank you for every email.
Hvala za vsak email.
Thank you for every kavico.
Hvala za vsako kavico. SMS.
When you get together,
ko se vi dobite skupaj,
and simply, ko ste zmožni tudi drug drugega opominjati, poučevati, spodbujevati, this is the strength and life of the church.
To je potem moč. Cerkve in življenje.
It hangs on all of us.
In to je odvisno od vsakega posameznika, od vsakega izmed nas.
As all of us grow together to become more and more mature and more and more like Christ.
Če dalje bolj zreli in če dalje bolj podobni Kristusu.
Equipped with all the tools and all the weapons that he's provided.
Z vsem orodjem in z vsem orožjem, ki ga je Bog poskrbel za nas.
Oh, you're not feeling well?
Kaj, ne počutiš se dobro?
Can I pray for you?
A lahko molim zate?
Oh, you're being, wow, it sounds like the enemy's attacking you.
Zgledaš kot da obremenjen, kot da te sovražnik napada.
Hey, let's pray together and resist him.
Dajmo se skupaj zoperstaviti.
And over again, we provide the context for victory for one another.
Znova poskrbimo za zmago drug drugemu.
Igor, I want to invite you back with the band.
Igor, želim povabiti nazaj.
I want to sing your new song again.
Želim, da skupaj zapojamo tvojo novo pesem.
Bog, tebi želim. Fantastic. And I want to invite the eldership, if you would please come.
Starešinstvo, da pride.
Stanko, would you join, please?
Stanko, če se Branka. Branki.
V molitvi.
V molitvi.
If you've got a need this morning as we conclude,
jutru, ko zaključujemo,
if you need a miracle in your body, if there's some other kind of obremenito and you want to agree with someone, either for that sickness to be broken, for that pressure to be removed, then take advantage of the strength of the body. In Jesus' name, I bless you, MKS. I thank you for who you are and what you're becoming. I thank you for the value that you put on people. Keep it up. And protect it.
In varujte to.
Protect one another.
Varujte drug drugega.
We're all imperfect.
Vsi smo nepopolni.
We're all a work under construction.
Vsi smo še delo otroci v obdelavi.
And
v obdelavi.
And what happens when you go on a construction site?
Kaj se zgodi, ko je na gradbišču?
You're very careful where you step.
Pazljivo gledaš, kje hodiš, ne?
And you know that this, what I see,
in veš, da to, kar zdala vidiš,
is not the finished product.
Še ni končni izdelek.
It is a product in process. So are you.
Tako si tudi ti.
So am I.
Tako sem tudi jaz.
Let's love God and love
ljubimo
one another.
Boga in ljubimo drug drugega.
If you have a need, come
imate potrebo,
and...